Let's consider the limit as n approaches infinity of n raised to the power of 1 divided by n. Notice as n approaches infinity, the base n gets larger and larger, but the exponent of 1 divided by n approaches 0. We have the indeterminate form of infinity raised to the power of 0. This does not mean the limit doesn't exist. This just means we'll have to take a different approach. So we begin by setting the limit equal to L, and now to change the order of the equation. From here, we'll take the natural log of both sides of the equation. This gives us natural log L equals natural log of the limit as n approaches infinity of n raised to the power of 1 divided by n. And now we'll use the property of limits where we can move the natural log inside the limit and write the right side as the limit as n approaches infinity of natural log of n raised to the power of 1 divided by n. And now we'll use the power property of logs, which states natural log of x to the power of b equals b times natural log x. This indicates we can write the right side of the equation as the limit as n approaches infinity of 1 divided by n times natural log n. Let's go ahead and write this as a quotient and write this as the limit as n approaches infinity of natural log n divided by n. And now if we consider the limit again in this form, as n approaches infinity, we have the indeterminate form of infinity divided by infinity, but now we can apply L'Hopital's rule, which indicates this limit is equal to the limit as n approaches infinity of the derivative of the numerator with respect to n divided by the derivative of the denominator with respect to n. The derivative of natural log n with respect to n is 1 divided by n. The derivative of n with respect to n is 1. We now have natural log L equals the limit as n approaches infinity of 1 divided by n divided by 1, or just the limit as n approaches infinity of 1 divided by n. And now we can actually determine the limit in this form. Notice the values of the fractions get smaller and smaller as n approaches infinity, and therefore the limit is equal to 0, giving us the equation natural log L equals 0. But don't forget we're looking for L, not natural log L, so now we'll have to solve this log equation for L by writing the log equation as an exponential equation. Remember that natural log x equals y is equivalent to e to the power of y equals x. Remember, natural log is base e, and a logarithm is an exponent, which indicates natural log L equals 0 is equivalent to e raised to the power of 0 equals L. Again, to form the exponential equation, natural log is base e, and then to form the equation, we work around the equal sign, giving us e to the power of 0 equals L. And e to the power of 0 is 1, and therefore L equals 1, which is the value of the original limit. We now know the limit as n approaches infinity of n to the power of 1 divided by n equals 1. I hope you found this helpful.